Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Wa salatu wa salamu ala sayyidil mursaleen. Wa ala alihi wa ashabihi ajma'in. Amma ba'd, fa'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajim. Bismillahir rahmanir rahim. Wa idha sa'alaka ibadi anni fa'inni qareeb. Ujibu da'awata da'i idha da'an. فَلْيَسْتَجِيبُوا لِي وَلْيُؤْمِنُوا بِي لَعَلَّهُمْ يَرْشُدُونَ صَدَقَ اللَّهُ مَوْلَانَا الْعَظِيمُ الصَّلَاةُ وَالسَّلَامُ عَلَيْكَ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ وَعَلَى آلِكَ وَأَصْحَابِكَ يَا نُورَ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ تَعَالَى عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ Inshallah, in this final clip, I want to bring to you something which is related to Ramadan, and we do engage in it, but we don't quite realize. You know, after we finish our fast, we make dua just before iftar. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has said that the dua of the person who makes dua before iftar is not rejected. Now, very interestingly, Allah Ta'ala, after He finishes mentioning about Ramadan in the Quran, immediately He mentions about dua. So there is this connection that we have fasted for Allah for the entire day. Now it is time to ask Allah. But how does Allah Ta'ala put it to us? I want to go through that ayat with you, inshallah. Allah Ta'ala says, وَإِذَا, the first thing, when my servant, not if. It's like saying, for example, if I am going away, my family would say to me, when you come back, I'm going to do this for you. I'm going to prepare this for you. When? And not if you come back. Why don't they say if you come back? Because they expect me. In the same way, Allah said, when my servant, whenever that is, whenever he comes to you, O beloved sallallahu alayhi wasallam, asking about me. Allah didn't say if. Why? Because Allah is showing that He is expecting us. He is waiting. So when, وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ, they ask you, عِبَادِ عَنِّي, my servant ask you about me, O beloved sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Now in those days, they would go to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, asking about Allah. What did Allah say? فَإِنِّي قَرِيب. Allah said, tell those people who are looking for me, I am very close to them. I am not far at all. They have their concerns, they have their questions, they have their, you know, duas for me. The first word of comfort which Allah made was, I am close, I am qareeb, I am listening. And one more thing here is that when you ask the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you will always find Allah qareeb, you will always find Allah close. And now when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is not in front of us, if we make dua with the wasila of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, then Allah is qareeb. Then Allah says, ujibu da'wata da'i idha da'an. Allah responds to each and every call of each and every caller. It doesn't matter that the caller has come to Allah after a year. The last time he came to the masjid or made dua was last Ramadan. He has come back to Allah. Allah is not saying, where were you for the entire year? Allah is saying, when you are asking me, I am qareeb. I am going to respond, not only listen. I am going to respond to each and every call of yours. Whoever makes a call, whenever he makes a call to Allah, Allah says, I am listening. And I am not only listening, I am responding to it. So keep asking Allah. Then Allah says, فَلْيَسْتَجِيبُوا لِي. The only condition is, you start obeying me. You want me to listen to you, then you should listen to me too. Start obeying me. Along with that, وَلْيُؤْمِنُوا بِي. Then have faith in me. When you are asking me, I am all powerful. I am completely capable. I can give what you want. In fact, I'll give you better. So don't lose faith. Don't lose hope. Have faith in me. لَعَلَّهُمْ yarshudun, so that you are guided. So alhamdulillah, this ayat teaches us to make dua, to turn to Allah. Allah will never reject us. He is always there for us. He is closer to us than we think. And He will always respond to each and every call we make, no matter where we are or what the call is. May Allah give us the tawfiq. Wa akhiru da'wana. Anilhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.